Metals and non-metals. These metals and non-metals are elements, and these are basically building block of universe. So let us see how many elements are present on the earth surface, sea, water, in human body. So here I have given you some comparisons. So on earth surface, if you take the concentration by in percentage, so oxygen is the highest percent. It is something about 47%, followed by silicon, aluminium, iron, calcium, sodium, potassium, magnesium, titanium, hydrogen, carbon, decreasing order. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 sodium. So these are the concentrations. In metals, first is aluminium. In metals, first is aluminium, then second is your iron, and third is your calcium. Aluminium is 8.3%. Sometimes this is asked in the examinations, which is the most abundant metal found on the earth surface. So aluminium is almost, it is highest. These two are non-metals. If you take all the elements, there are 10 non-metals, which is solid state, 1 non-metal in liquid state, and 11 non-metals are gases. So there are almost, how many metals? 22 non-metals are present there in the periodic table. Now let's see, in human body, this is the concentration, highest is hydrogen, followed by oxygen, carbon, nitrogen, calcium, phosphorus, chlorine, potassium, sulfur, sodium, and magnesium. Now let us see color of some metals and non-metals. If you see in metals, colored metals are very less. Gold, yellow in color, silver white, that is naturally, copper, reddish brown. Rest of the metals are white in color. In non-metals, sulfur is yellow, phosphorus white or red, graphite black, fluorine light yellow in color, chlorine yellowish green, bromine reddish brown, iodine deep violet. Now there are some terms which is associated with the metals. Specific metals, some metals are like base metal, precious metals, and strategic metals. What is base metal? Base metals are called as inexpensive metals, very very expensive, that oxidizes. Inexpensive means less cost, it's very low cost. So these are those metals which oxidize or corrodes relatively easily and react variably with dilute HCl, or widely or rarely extracted from the earth, like copper, lead, nickel, iron, zinc. So these are the metals which is readily extracted from the earth and widely available also. Precious metals, less in on the surface of the earth, ruthenium, rhodium, palladium, osmium, iridium, platinum, silver, gold, and also they are very very costly. Strategic metals, those metals which require for economic development and national defense for country. They are widely used as jet fuels, space research, atomic plants. So this is developed for the some development of the country, like manganese, titanium, zirconium, chromium. So they are also resistant to acid and base, or highly they are also resistant to corrosions. So these are also strategic metals. Now difference between physical properties of metals and non-metals. So here I have collected the difference between how metals and non-metals are separate on basis of physical properties. Physical states, generally metals are solid at room temperature, but these exist as solid or gas, both possible. Exception is bromine. Here some exceptions are mercury, cesium, gallium. So they are, mercury is liquid, but cesium is liquid after 28.5 degree centigrade, and gallium 29.7. means if you place in hand whose temperature is 37 degree centigrade, it will melt down. Cesium and gallium will melt down if you put on hand. Okay, melting point and boiling point. So here metals are high, exception sodium, potassium, tungsten. Tungsten is the highest melting point. That's why this is used in bulb filament. Bulb filament. For non-metals, they have low, exception carbon, silicon bond, they have high melting point, boiling point. This one high. Hardness, if you take garnet, diamond, they have a high melting point and boiling point. If you take a hardness of metal, they are very hard, exception sodium, potassium, mercury. They are so soft that you can cut by knife. Sodium, potassium, mercury, liquid state. They are soft, like example, diamond. Diamond is not soft, it is very hard. Lustres, so they are bright and metallic and silvery white in color. Why they are lustrous? Because they have loose electrons. They have loose electrons which oscillates inside the metals. They have loose electrons which oscillates inside metal. So due to these oscillations, what happens? shining appears in the metals and their shines. Same phenomena also happens with the iodine and graphite also. So they also shine. Otherwise, non-metals are lacklusters. Density-wise, they are very high, except in sodium, potassium, calcium. They float on water, very lightest. Highest density is iridium followed by osmium. This is the highest density which is present in the periodic table among the metals. Malleability. Malleability means which can be converted into seeds. So malleable wise, gold is the first one followed by silver. So here no malleable property with non-metals. Ductile means metal you can convert into wires. Here silver is the best. In non-metals nobody is there. Tenacity means which have some stretching power, which can stretch, and after stretching it will not be stretched properly. It will not be stretched. They are holding very powerful. Means here if you can stretch it, but after stretching it will not be stretched like a rubber. They will stretch but not like rubber. So after stretching it will gain your own shape. High, they have high tenacity, metals high, but here non-metals they do not have a high tenacity. Example, exception, sodium, potassium, if you stretch it, they will stretch it properly and after they will not gain it. So here tenacity is very low. Brittleness, hard but not brittle, exception, zinc at room temperature. So this is only zinc which is brittle at room temperature. Here non-metals are brittle in nature. Conductors. Conductance, good conductor of heat and electricity, silver is the best, followed by copper, then gold. Exception is bismuth, lead, they are the bad conductor of heat and electricity. In non-metals, they are very bad except graphite and gaseous carbon, they are good conductors. Solubility, they do not dissolve in liquid, they dissolve in liquid solvents, this is non-metals. They do not dissolve liquid like water, they dissolve in water. Any other liquids, alcohol, so many non-polar solvents are there in which they can easily dissolve it. Alloys and amalgams, you can make alloys and amalgams, and they do not form alloys except carbon, which alloys with iron to form steels. So these are the basically physical properties between metals and non-metals.